Hi and welcome back. Today I am going to show you how to design a custom spur gear in a very easy way, using SolidWorks 2022. By watching this SolidWorks tutorial, you will learn the technique of 3D CAD designing of a spur gear like a professional. By watching this tutorial, you will learn the use of SolidWorks feature tools like boss extrude, circular pattern, revolve cut, etc. Hope you will stay connected with us and continue learning advanced part modeling by SolidWorks 2022. Hope you will love the way we design the custom-made spur gear by using SolidWorks 2022. So, let's get started. Click on new part. First select plain white from the apply scene option. Go to the option, document properties, image quality. Select high quality for the best image quality. Now select material from the material menu. Let's select brass. You can choose whatever you like. First, click on the front plane and start the sketch. Take circle command and draw circles like me. The outer circle diameter is 180 mm. The inner circle diameter is 70 mm. Let's extrude this sketch. Extrude depth is 25 mm. We gonna create the teeth of the spur gear. Start a sketch on the front plane. Take convert entities commands and convert this edge into a circle. Draw one more circle like me. The diameter of the circle is 200 mm. Draw a construction line like me. Make sure it is vertical. Draw an arc, like me. Make sure the endpoints of the arc are coincident with those circles. This distance is 2 mm. This distance is 5 mm. The radius of the arc is 15 mm. Mirror this arc. Mirror about the construction line. Trim unwanted lines. Perfect. Let's extrude the sketch. Extrude depth is 25 mm, and choose merge result. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now use the circular pattern command. Select this face for pattern direction. Select the boss extrude 2 for the pattern. The degree of the pattern is 360 and the instances are 45. Press OK to complete the command. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now we gonna remove some extra parts of materials by using the revolve cut command. Start a sketch on the right plane. Draw a construction line connecting the midpoint of these lines. Press Ctrl plus 8. Draw a profile like me. This angle is 15 degrees. Make the point and edge coincident. Because we only remove the material from the teeth only. The extended part of the profile is fine because it will not affect the design. Let's mirror this profile about the construction line. Press OK to close the command. Let's make the temporary axis visible. Use Revolve Cut about the center axis. The cut angle is 360 degrees. Hide the temporary axis. Press the space button and select isometric view. Now we gonna create the inner teeth. Sketch on the front plane. Convert the inner edge into a circle. Create one more circle. The diameter of the circle is 60 millimeters. Draw a construction line. Make it vertical. Draw a line, whose edges are coincident with these circles. This distance is 5 millimeters. This distance is 3 millimeters. Mirror this line about the construction line. Trim unwanted lines. Now extrude the profile. The depth is 25 millimeters. Choose merge result. Click on the edge and select chamfer. Chamfer distance is 0.5 millimeters and angle 45 degrees. Press the space button and select isometric view. Let's use a circular pattern. Select this face for pattern direction. Pattern instances are 10. Select extrude 3 and chamfer 1 for the pattern. Press OK to complete the pattern command. Press the space button and select isometric view. For the next operation, we need to use section view. Use section view about the top plane. Make the top plane visible. Take line command and draw a profile like me. Make the temporary axis visible. This distance is 45 millimeters. Hide temporary axis. The angle is 75 degrees. This angle is 60 degrees. Delete the relation and reposition like me. This length is 15 millimeters. This arm is 10 millimeters. This distance is 6 millimeters. The sketch is fully defined. Hide axis. Take line command and draw a profile like me. Control select these two corner points and make them vertical. This angle is 45 degrees. This angle is 65 degrees. Show temporary axis. This distance is 55 millimeters. The width of the profile is 7 millimeters. The sketch is fully defined. Use Revolve Cut about the temporary axis. Press OK to complete the Revolve Cut. Hide temporary axis. Press the space button and select isometric view. Turn off section view. Left click on the surface and select sketch. Select the edge and convert it into a circle. Draw a circle. The diameter of the circle is 85 millimeters. Now extrude the profile. The depth is 15 millimeters. Select merge result. Start a new sketch on the top plane. Draw a rectangle like me. The width is 8 millimeters. This distance is 5 millimeters. This distance is 1 millimeter. The sketch is fully defined. Show temporary axis. Use Revolve Cut around a temporary axis. Hide temporary axis. Press the space button and select isometric view. Left click on the edge and select chamfer. Chamfer distance is 2 mm and angle 45 degrees. On this edge, the chamfer distance is 3 millimeters. Use filler on this corner. The filler radius is 5 millimeters. Here filler radius is 15 millimeters. Use 10 mm filler on this corner. And 5 mm filler on this corner. Press the space button and select isometric view. Congratulations! This is the final custom design spur gear that we were trying to build using SolidWorks 2022. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you are watching this video on Facebook, please like and share. Because your engagement encourages me to upload new tutorials. Please also let me know your thought about this tutorial through comments. Thanks for your time.